Hey guys, welcome to another video, and in this video we are going to explain how to crack GRE verbal. This video is going to be specifically verbal because verbal is the component where everybody has more trouble. Quant is still reachable and quant is still easier than the verbal part, and I have had a couple of people mailing me the same that they cannot crack verbal. So I have my friend Shoaib who's studying in the same program as me.
Hi everybody, I'm Shoaib. I'm currently in my first year of master's at Purdue's Building Construction Management program. I wrote my GRE in November of last year. My GRE split was 167 in verbal and 165 in quant.
Insane.
I can't do that math.
Insane. That's a total of 332.
Luckily, that was good. Touch wood. And I have my undergraduate civil engineering degree from BITS Pilani, Hyderabad campus. And I'm from Hyderabad, basically, born and raised. And I thought we could help you guys out with your GRE verbal part.
Because every time I'm getting a query, people are asking me how to crack verbal. And I can just only say to tell them that I did not score that well, but I can give you some tips. And I found out that Shoaib scored this well. I thought there'll be a great platform to help a lot of students. And go ahead with the strategies, and we'll talk about how he started studying for verbal, how he cracked it in 1 month and 10 days. I'll give the mic to Shoaib and he can continue.
When I started, I didn't know when I would give my GRE, so I had my timeline down to 2 months. But for any of you who are starting to prepare for GRE, who feel they need to give adequate attention to verbal, I would say put your timeline down to 3 to 4 months. That's a good timeline. It will help you grow because you need to see your growth so that you're encouraged to keep it up. And if you give yourself a really short time, you may end up burning out and giving up hopes on verbal. It can be trying, so have patience and give yourself time enough. Well, I'll start with how I started. I got down my material first, what all I wanted to study from. And since I did not have anybody to guide me, I had to keep improving on my material, but I can suggest material for you. What I used was the best book you will have is the GRE official guide, the GRE official quant book, the GRE official verbal book, and the GRE official combined guide. I understand there are a few questions that are repeated in among those three books, but still they are the best three books you will have to prepare. Yeah. Only problem is there are very few questions in those. So you need more questions so you can practice for 4 months. For practice, you will take the Manhattan 5-pound book, or if you've taken Princeton training, then you will have the Princeton book. But you should know that these questions are much more difficult than the actual questions you will face in GRE. So you can only use them after you've mastered verbal to a certain level. You will use them as extra practice. But always remember that the difficulty will be exactly as the GRE official books. Another source that is more accurate and close to the actual GRE questions is the Kaplan test program. Now, I'm not sure how you will get access to it, but if you want, you will look up Kaplan GRE Premier. This is
just to make a point, I'm going to link all the resources which Shoaib is telling in the description. I've mentioned already the books I have used, and every book's Amazon link is down below. We cannot post the free drive, but if you look up on WhatsApp groups, everybody has PDF versions of all the books. And you can find free PDF versions of all these books and all the resources as well. You can get Kaplan test for free as well. There's always a loophole to that. Still, I'll link all these so that you can check them out. And if you get a free resource, it's always better to pay for something.
I did not pay for any of these resources. I found out from people and I got it from friends. So please look hard and you will find these. So I was saying official GRE, Manhattan 5-pound. The Kaplan GRE Premier 2016 is what I use. 2017 is out now. You will have your Magush material. Really helpful. And Magush is your starting point. You will start with Magush.
The point here we are making is Magush, you don't have to buy the Magush pack, which is $100 or $120 or something. Right. There's a free Magush app for iOS and Android. You can download it and then Shoaib can talk about how you can crack.
As you all know very well, verbal requires you to know a lot of words. There are a lot of numbers out there. Some say 1,000 words, some say 2,000, some say 3,000. I have set my number down to the exact number of words that are there in the Magush app, around 900 something. They're split in three sets. The Magush app comes as flashcards, so that is very helpful. You see the word, you guess its meaning, and then when you click on it, you actually see its meaning. So that is really helpful. You will start off with your Magush vocabulary app for words. The breakdown of the exam is you will have text completion questions, which are fill in the blanks. You will have reading comprehension questions, where you read a passage and answer questions that follow. There will be sentence equivalence questions. And is there any other?
No, that's about it.
They used to have logic-based reading comprehension. They don't have those anymore. So that's the three types of questions you will face. And the key to all of them is knowing the right kind of words and their correct usage. That's the important part. So after we start with the apps and we do the words, we also have to learn in what sense they can be used.
I would like to mention one point that for reading comprehensions, because it's the most difficult part in all the three types of questions we have, we are going to make another separate video, which will be coming following week or like in the middle of the week. We'll be just talking about how to crack RCs.
I'll also tell you how I my regimen, how I used to take it every day with verbal, because that is important. If you just start with the words, you may get to 300, 400 and then you'll feel cramped up in your head with too many new words and your retention capacity is lost basically. So how you take up the app, sit down for an hour, 2 hours, whatever it takes, and just do 30 to 40 words a day. From the app, that is one set in the Magush app, very neatly divided. And once you have all those words, and also simultaneously write these words down as a reference list later. At the end of your prep, you will have a master list with a lot more words than you actually did in the app, because you will also write down any related words that you come across.
Synonyms, maybe.
Synonyms, because when you find a word that you do not know in the app, when you're writing the exams, when you're preparing, or when you do any kind of question, look up the word on Google, note its synonyms, don't write them down yet, because then for every word you will actually be learning 7 new words. We don't want to do that either.
Yeah.
Just look them up so you know what the synonyms are and that there are so many synonyms. That knowledge is good enough for now. And you will learn its meaning. I don't know about pronunciation. It won't ever be tested in your GRE, but
for
it never hurts.
TOEFL also, you don't need.
You don't really need to know the pronunciation, but if you enjoy the process, it's much better and it'll be much easier for you. So maybe learn the pronunciation.
I would agree on one thing, that stick to 30 to 40 words per day and try to revise them by the end of the week or on the weekends, because it's difficult for human brain to like process that many words on one day.
Yes.
Also, app is a great way to learn words because it keeps you hooked to the words. If I'm going to through barons and I'm doing like the list of words, it's difficult for me to like keep that concentration for a long time.
The flashcards are a great way in the app. And I would also suggest, after you're done with your words, if you come back in your weekend review, right, then you see some words that are very difficult. Fortunately, there'll be very few, about 10 to 20 words that you just can't remember. Write them down on your own flashcards. You know, the more difficult the word, the more innovative the technique you'll have to come up with to keep up with their meanings and to remember them. It's not at all a challenge. You're just fighting your own retention capacity. So keep coming up with more innovative ways to do that. And another very important thing in that is mnemonics. It's the way your brain likes to remember words, associating it with a picture or some kind of imagery. You can fake that process too. You can create your own mnemonic for any word that you would want. For example, you will also see this in the Magush examples, and that's what I picked it up from. Lambaste. Lambaste is a GRE word that means to criticize harshly. Mm-hmm. And I don't know. You can think of it as a piece of lamb kept to baste. Baste is to put it in an oven and so it gets angry at you.
So you're connecting two words.
You're breaking down the word, making a mental imagery to remember that word. Now, lambaste stays with me for life. Even though it's not my mnemonic, I got it from somebody's video. He did it so well that I just remember it now.
Yeah, well, I'm going to link a couple of websites where you can look up. Even if you search just mnemonics on Google, there will be a couple of websites which will come up and you can look how the process works and it'll help you.
So look into that as well. That is all about building your vocabulary, and that is key to whatever comes next with respect to verbal. let it happen in the background. Like I said, 1 or 2 hours a day at the most in your 4 months, you will focus on words. But by the end of the 4 months, your vocabulary would have increased by a lot. So take the process slow. Now, after vocabulary, you will do what we do for any other exam. You will pick up practice questions from your Manhattan book or from the Kaplan book, whichever you're most comfortable with. But earlier in the video, I've already said which one's the closest to the actual GRE questions. You have to keep that in mind.
Kaplan is
the closest to actual GRE questions also, after the official GRE book.
Yeah. And also GRE Power Prep for the test. But that comes up in the last, like...
So, and you will do this every day, and every weekend you will give a full-length test. And also, before you start your preparation, give one test as a diagnostic measure, trying to find out where are your strengths and where are your faults. So, right off the bat, you know which you should allot the most time to. It'll help you because most people get RC, and that is a good realization. You don't want to realize that 1 month down the line. That RC is really your weak point. You can start off with that. My first test scores were 145 and 147. It was less than 280.
Yeah.
So
don't get demotivated by
don't
that.
Don't get discouraged.
Yeah, discouraged. Yeah.
You haven't ever seen the format of the test. That's how the test score was supposed to look like. Even if it's 260, 250, do not get discouraged. It'll be good for you in the end when you see growth. It'll actually help you stay focused.
Yeah.
For verbal overall, your words are most important. So all my tips revolve around your memory retention capacity.
If you cannot, just mug up. If you don't want to understand the meaning, just mug up.
It'll be easier for RC if you don't mug up the words, if you really understand their meaning. In the following RC video, I will have brought up the point where I'll tell you that don't mug up.
That's why I messed up and he didn't.
Don't mug up the words, really try and understand them. And to help you with that, Google every word you don't know before writing it down or before committing it to memory. Google has so many interesting things that it shows you about a word.
It'll take time, but you gotta do what you gotta
try,
do. Score good.
Try and make the process as interesting as possible for yourself, because it is laborious and it is lengthy, and it tries to challenge your brain in a way that other exams don't.
Yeah, you tend to give up as well.
Tend to give up. Other
I gave up on verbal totally. Like, that's the one mistake that people commit every day, that they give up on verbal and they think that because they'll score good in quant, it'll be fine. But then the end up score is a total of your verbal and quant. If you mess up one, then your total score will be messed up.
And verbal is a goal within reach. All you need is a little bit of perseverance. Take it slow. Be smart about it. You're running in the long race, so take one step at a time and you should be good.
Yeah.
That's all I have.
So that was the tips on how to crack verbal. Shoya scored 167. I'm going to link all the things we have mentioned, all the resources we have mentioned in the description below. You can check that out. Also, the RC video will be coming in the following week, in the mid of the week, something like that, as soon as I edit it. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. Hit the like button if you think this was useful, and subscribe if you haven't yet. Until then, I'll see you on the next one.